Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today. We're getting several news regarding second wave of COVID-19 from various parts of the world, and we hope that you and your family are safe. Today, we have four latest updates for you. Up till now, SpaceX launched three crewed flights on its Crew Dragon spacecraft. The recent crew launches supported astronauts from NASA, as well as the European and Japanese space agencies. Now, SpaceX's next Crew Dragon launch may have Roscosmos astronauts aboard the spacecraft. NASA and Russian space agency Roscosmos are planning to exchange seats on the rides to the International Space Station. According to the plan, U.S. commercial vehicles like SpaceX's Crew Dragon can launch Russian cosmonauts to the space station, while NASA astronauts will continue to fly on Russian Soyuz vehicles, although it comes with several negotiations of both space agencies. In fact, after months of negotiations, they haven't made it official yet. Of course, we would be honored to fly cosmonauts on Dragon, but I do not have any insight into any potential objections, Musk stated at NASA's press conference on April 23rd. Perhaps this may just be a communications breakdown, I don't know. Meanwhile, Kathy Luters of NASA's Human Exploration and Operations stated, "We're working through the agreements right now. People understand the importance of crew swaps for supportability of ISS, and so we're working through that and getting that agreement in place. It takes a while sometimes, I found out. There's lots of people to coordinate with, so it doesn't happen as fast probably as I want it to, but we're working through it." According to NASA Active Administrator Steve Jurczyk, Roscosmos will put their cosmonauts on SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft after three successful Crew Dragon launches, but some arrangements can be made to have a Russian cosmonaut on board the Crew 3 launch. However, it might be difficult given the fact that Crew 3 launch is scheduled in October. "We haven't completely given up on having a cosmonaut on Crew 3," Jurczyk stated, "but at this point, given the schedule, it'd be really, really challenging to complete all the training, get the suit fitted and done for a cosmonaut on Crew 3. Therefore, we might see Russian cosmonauts flying in SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule next year." Let's move on to our next segment regarding SpaceX Crew Dragon first nighttime splashdown with U.S. astronauts since the Apollo era. SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule Resilience safely comes home with four astronauts. On Sunday, May 2nd, SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule conducted an ocean splashdown off the Florida coast, returning Crew 1 astronauts to Earth. This splashdown put curtains to SpaceX's first crewed mission to the International Space Station. NASA astronaut Shannon Walker, Victor Glover, Michael Hopkins, and JAXA astronaut Soichi Noguchi inside Space Station's Crew Dragon capsule landed in the Gulf of Mexico near Panama City at 2:56 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. A recovery ship waiting there retrieved the Crew Dragon capsule from the ocean. It marked the first nighttime splashdown of a U.S. crewed spacecraft in 53 years, after NASA's Apollo 8 moon mission on December 28, 1968. NASA's Crew Dragon capsule left from the International Space Station at about 8:35 p.m. Eastern on Saturday, May 1st. The capsule conducted two small engine burns to separate the spacecraft from the space station. Then the capsule conducted four departure burns and began its journey to return to Earth. The crew originally planned a daytime splashdown on Wednesday, April 28th, but it was postponed due to bad weather. Later, NASA changed it to a nighttime landing. The reason behind this decision is that SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule will not attract private boats during its splashdown. Last year, when Demo 2 spacecraft conducted an ocean landing in August, several private boats gathered nearby to see the splashdown. Another advantage of nighttime splashdown is that a calm nighttime weather with moonlight sparkling on water creates a spectacular atmosphere for astronauts to return home. In addition, the capsule is developed to conduct both daytime and nighttime landing. NASA's Commercial Crew Program Manager Steve Stitch stated, "The vehicle is certified to land during the day or night, so there's not an issue with the vehicle itself. And we've been practicing with the recovery crews to land in day or night." The Crew 1 astronauts were recovered by SpaceX team about 30 minutes after the splashdown. a SpaceX crew operations and resource engineer, welcomed the Crew 1 astronauts for safely returning to Earth. Dragon, on behalf of NASA and SpaceX teams, we welcome you back to planet Earth, and thanks for flying SpaceX. For those of you enrolled in our frequent flyer program, you've earned 68 million miles, 109 million kilometers on this voyage, he said. It's good to be back on planet Earth, replied NASA astronaut and commander of the Crew 1 mission, Mike Hopkins. SpaceX recovery team helped astronauts to step out from the spacecraft one by one. Hopkins came out first of the Dragon capsule. The crews were taken to NASA's Johnson Space Center at Houston. It's not very often you get to wake up on the space station and go to sleep in Houston, so we've been talking about that in the control center, Holly Ridings, NASA's chief flight director, stated. You know, orbital mechanics and the weather doesn't always work out, but today they did, and so that's pretty remarkable. The Crew 1 astronauts spent 167 days on the space station and completed a total of 2,688 orbits of Earth. This is our first full-up crew rotation mission. We, on the NASA side, and I know on the SpaceX side, learned a lot. Kathy Luters, Associate Administrator of NASA's Human Exploration and Operations, stated, I don't know how you could have done this one much better. Currently, the Crew 2 astronauts are on board the space station. They'll make a splashdown later this year. Let's move to our last news, based on Vega returning to flight. Recently, in a launch on the 28th of April 2021, a high-resolution satellite named Pleiades Neo 3 was deployed into orbit. This satellite, built and regulated by Airbus Defense and Space, has a length of 30 centimeters. On the 28th of April at 9:50 p.m. Eastern Time, the satellite was launched aboard a Vega rocket of European Space Agency, ESA, from the Guiana Space Center. After 1 hour and 42 minutes after liftoff, the payload was released from the rocket. In the rocket's small spacecraft mission service deployment system, five more payloads were there. The five supplementary payloads consisted of four CubeSats for Eutelsat, Nano Avionics, Aurora Insight, and Spire, and one NorSat 3 microsatellite for Norwegian Space Agency. According to Francois Lombard, head of intelligence of Airbus Defense and Space, Pleiades Neo 3 was the company's largest fully self-funded program. It took nearly 5 years to complete this project. Lombard said that only Maxar Technologies is providing 30-centimeter resolution imaging to the commercial customers using their WorldView constellation. Pleiades Neo 3 is the first satellite of its constellation of four identical imaging satellites. The Pleiades Neo program costs about $723 million to $848 million. According to a report, the second imaging satellite will be launched in July. Remaining two will be launched aboard a single Vega C rocket in early 2022. Report also says that the whole constellation will be able to cover at least two times any part of the Earth. It will relieve the pressure on lower resolution orbital and synthetic aperture radar satellites that Airbus has already operational in orbit. It's expected that this constellation will easily work for more than a decade. Lombard said the company has a good confidence in the future of these four identical satellites in the market of higher resolution imagery. Lombard said, "We'll grab a big part of this market. Our expectation is that this is a market that will continue to grow. Here I can say we benefit from the long relationship and trust in the Airbus technology." On the 29th of April 2021, Lombard said that they're already getting contracts from the US and a Chinese company has also signed up for their service. Maxar plans to launch the first two spacecraft of their WorldView Legion constellation in late 2021. Then, after 3 to 6 months, four WorldView Legion satellites will be launched. The WorldView Legion constellation, as intended, will be launched on SpaceX Falcon 9 rockets. That's all for today. Engineering Today wishes everyone a safe and healthy life. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.